Good afternoon and welcome to our spring concert. We're excited to perform for you today, and we're honored that so many of you came out to see our performance.
For some of us, this will be our last performance before we move on and begin to write the next chapter in our lives. We celebrate the unique way music touches our hearts, encourages our spirit, draws out our humanity, and embellishes our lives.
For some of us, music defines us as who we are as a person. For others, it is our place of solace and refuge in hard times. Whether we act, sing, dance, create, compose, or play, the arts provide us a place to build our confidence, discover our talents, find our voice, and heal our hearts.
We welcome our friends, families, and our alumni and their families today as we take a musical journey that will hopefully trigger some wonderful memories while it, at this moment, creates new ones.
Our opening song was written by Carly Simon. Working Girl in 1988. Carly drew inspiration for the song from the poems of Walt Whitman in the original script.
It was written as a hymn for the city of New York and becomes a hymn of working woman. The song is one of only three that has won the three major awards, Oscar, the Golden Globe, and the Grammy. Let the River Run.
Oh,
our story, not only as a person, but as a nation and a community. Whether it be our fight song, an alma mater, or top 40 hit of our senior year, it provides an unbreakable bond, a connection to each other that immediately creates a common memory, a feeling that lasts forever.
The Rock Group Queen was recently inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Their classic hit, We Are the Champions, became an anthem for sports teams for years. Who could forget our wrestling team entering the darkened gym to the rock anthem year after year? Queen's greatest hit album, number one, sold over 6 million records in 1981, making it the best-selling album of all time in Great Britain. To this day, their songs are used in video games, movies, commercials. We present Queen.
Oh, still in Queens.
Still in Queens.
Thank you.
1970s music scene reflected the many changes that were occurring in our country. We began a decade with... We began the 1970s saw the biggest change in musical styles ever in the U.S. history. The end of the Vietnam War brought a decrease in the amount of folk music and protest songs. With the inventions in electronics, we saw more diverse music with the birth of disco. Rock music grew into heavy metal. Rock, punk rock, and R&B music became infused with sounds of electronic piano and string instruments. Even country music experienced a change as artists began infusing rock beats and instruments into their sound, which gave birth into Southern rock.
Thank you.
Hotel California spent many months on the top of the Billboard charts. The band experienced longevity through the 80s and into the 1990s. Their music reflected a style that changed, sometimes Southern rock, at times country, folk, and hard rock. Today, we perform one of their later hits, Hole in the World, which was written after the 9/11 terrorist attack on our country. John Henley began writing it a few days after the attack, thinking of the senseless deaths of thousands and the hole that would be left in our hearts and of our loved ones. He finished it when he entered the tribe into the Iraq War, as he mourned for the families who would be affected again by losing their sons and daughters and family members due to it. Once again, it reflects the political times that we were experiencing as a nation. He spoke that the power of love is the ultimate savior over a world corrupted by hate and greed.
Successful group include John and Christine McVie. Mick Fleetwood, Steve Nicks, and Lindsey Buckingham. President Bill Clinton used the hit "Don't Stop Thinking About Tomorrow" as his theme song for his 1992 campaign and his run for president. As in the past, the song proved to be successful.
Each year, we highlight our seniors in their performance.
Come on. Where's Miss Sadie? Aw, you sure? Any other kids up there? Come on.
Thank you. Sing a song.
Each year, we highlight our seniors in a performance. The Broadway musical Rent hit the stage in later 1990s. The story was loosely based off of the opera La Bohème, written by Puccini. It tells the tale of struggling impoverished artists as they try to make it in New York City during the height of HIV/AIDS epidemic. The seniors will now perform the song No Day But Today, an anthem encouraging us to take each day and treat it as it as our last.
University. She's studying education. my white guy, he's never signed off for me. Skills and his composition, and to say that he's been an asset is putting it mildly. He can take care of this, and he can play, and he can pretty much do whatever I need to do. And I would say I was going to miss you, but I'm going to go up to him. To that glory of Mr. Frank is the only thing. He is involved in the Berklee School of Music's online program. Alexis has been singing with me for many years. Awesome soloist today on Somebody's Love. I'm going to Hofstra University. Thank you very much. Another one that's always helping me. Oops. Thank God it got cool in here. Miss Rayanne. Rayanne, talk up. And you will be going
to Arcadia University.
Which is another one that didn't get to take my class, but she still was there after school. And I really do appreciate how many of you are on the stage that are not enrolled in the class, but still make the effort to come and learn their music. Some of them you can tell by the way they move their mouths that they didn't learn all of it, but they did get there. So thank you. Miss Kate. Caitlin Winters, I went to school with her dad.
That's one of the nice things about working in your community, is you can see people that, you're like, I know your father, or I know the football coach, and I have his number, so I can call him if he misbehaves in my classroom.
Miss Kate is a very talented artist. Been talented at a lot of things. She'll be putting up the slideshow. Later, you may even see yourselves up there someplace. Kate is going to Empire Beauty School. Which is good. So, enjoy the class and Mr. Jude. To his junior, Jude unfortunately was singing in the hall and I caught him. That's how I caught a lot of my kids, singing in the hall, like, yeah, okay, you gotta try and help me out. Jude is going to
Lotz University.
Lotz University, and you're doing thank you, sir, for putting up with me and deciding to join our group, even though you really weren't given much of a choice. Miss Kaylee Martinelli, another one of our students. Miss Kaylee is going to, I think, Temple, right?
Media Studies and Production.
Media Studies and Production. But she's been in the choir. How long have I been with you guys? 4 years or three?
Four.
I can't remember. Okay, 4 years. So that's good. We're good. We're back to having 4 years with you. And did all our plays, did Disney with me. So thank you for all your help and all of your extra time. I appreciate it. Oh, that was a concert today from what I heard. Actor. Cole, did we get Cole before you two started dating or after you two started dating? After you two started dating? Cole was another one I grabbed out of the hall to just give him a little cameo. And the next thing you know, he's got the lead in the play and he's one of my top players. Just goes to show you could sort of hook him in. Everybody gets him. You are going to
St. Joseph's University.
St. Joseph. And he's playing baseball so that you can sing the national anthem before the games for them. I'll make sure I email your coach and tell him that. Shawnee's sort of special. Not that you aren't all special. But Shawnee used to get off the bus on St. Ann Street every day. And he would yell, "Hello, Mr. Evans," to my father. And every time I saw him, my dad, he would say, "That Sean Fanning is such a good boy. He says hello to me every morning and he always has a smile on his face." And thank you, because you made my dad smile. Now, that's my seniors. There are a couple that are missing. Out there in the world, Diana. Oh my God, Miss Diana. I'm like, who am I missing? Okay, Diana. Diana has been a remarkable musician for me. And the word no has never come out of her mouth. Whenever I've needed her to play something or help me with something, transpose something, she is a very talented young lady, and I don't know what I would have done without having an accompanist. And yes, she's leaving with me too, so gotta find an accompanist. You guys, where we are, gotta find an accompanist. You are going to?
LaSalle University.
LaSalle University to study
international business.
International business. Awesome. Now, you heard where they're going. We've had kids at Fordham. I've had students that have gone to Fordham, that have gone to NYU, that have gone to Brown, that have gone to Colgate, that have gone to the University of Pennsylvania, that have gone to USC. This small little community school prepares them very well. And I'm very proud of them. And sometimes my own kids get mad because I say they're one of mine. But I know there's teachers out there, and they, you know what I mean when you say they're one of mine. We take that whether it's good or bad. Whether it's good or bad. There has been some bad that we've seen here and there. And we've had to say, well, yeah, they were one of mine. But one of my needs, you have to keep your bar held high. Because we have doctors. I have doctors. I have lawyers. I have Fulbright scholars. I have college professors. I have a million wonderful teachers out there, and some of them I know are here with me today. And you have the ability to make this world as beautiful as it could possibly be. And the one thing that I've always said about my kids from West Grand High School are they are the most compassionate students. They take care of one another. And that's how this small school works. We take care of one another. Today, in the audience, are my girlfriends from high school. The same people I stood on this chair, this stage with 38 girls, 38 years ago. And they're, you're going to keep your friends. And even though I won't be finishing up with you, I will check on you. And I will make sure I come around to see you. And you better make sure you keep singing. And keep it going. Okay? All right. Before, thank you. I have a little thank you. All right. You guys go to your spots on stage because we're going to do Wonderful World. Before we do Wonderful World, waiting at home for me to get home from work, for my late night rehearsals,
And my weekends and my 4 days at districts where poor Joe was left home with like a 2-year-old, a 4-year-old, and a 6-year-old while I was down at districts for 4 days for year after year after year. Thank you for patiently playing around the halls of the middle school and here. A lot of the kids that are hopefully out there to see us today remember Ian as a toddler being dragged here and there. The baby. I never called my name, it was always the baby. And when people see me, they still say, how's the baby? How's the baby? Well, who saw the baby? He doesn't look like a baby anymore. Thank you for not giving me a hard time when I missed important events because I was here or away. And I want to thank my sister Lori because she was always picking up the slack with my daughter Kylie, getting her hair done for her recitals and things when I was not around. So I appreciate that. You allowing me to do what I love to do. Sorry, I appreciate that I couldn't do this kind of thing with these guys up here and out there. And I wouldn't have as big of a family as we do now. We were our extended family without your support. I would like to recognize one of my dear friends, Mrs. Hazuri, and I hope she's here tonight, because for 20 years she has had a very, very difficult job. She has been the one who's had to do my program. All right? So she has been constantly having to change it, fixing names, fixing, which I still didn't fix Kaylee Tafina's name, I'm sorry. Fixing names, fixing, is she out there? She won't come up, will she? I know she won't come up. I know she won't come up. That has not been an easy task, and she's been doing it for over 20 years. I would miss her. She's been a very supportive colleague, and a lot of them have been out there, and I couldn't have done it without you, so thank you. To the rest of my family and my friends who patiently waited until the summer to catch up with me, Trez, Robin, JoJo, all of you, I know you're busy, but thank you for always being there. And now we have time to do lunch. And dinner, and well for pizza and prosecco. Thank you for your constant support and always understanding. Okay, I'm gonna have to take these off and do this. To my former students, and you guys are constantly, actually one of them now. There has never been a time where I have needed something that I haven't picked up the phone and said, it's Mrs. Lutz, can you help me? Just this week, on Friday, I sat in the first row of the audience and the class day stage was up. Now, if anyone was here on class day, you know it was up. And Mr. Lally's sitting next to me, he goes, how are you gonna get that done? And I looked down and I said, this is how. Took my cell phone, I text David Lutchville, Karen Lutchville, Bryce Shanny, and said, if you're not doing anything at 2:45, will you come over and help me? No problem. Sure, whatever you need. That's what this experience has given us. It's given us a community that takes care of one another and is always willing to help one another. So, I'm sorry. I'm going to keep your name and my cell phone, and I'm going to ask you for help. My daughter's been on tour all over. All I have to do is go on Facebook and say, so-and-so, I know you're in Arizona. Will you go see her at the show? And it's been an hour. So thank you to all of my alum who are always, always, always there to help me. We are part of a very special group of people, a community connected by the joy of music. We have traveled together, shared our successes and our sorrows. We're an extended family, one that for a few times each year comes together for one special performance. Each one, like today, only happens once. Each one is unique, and each one's different, and each one can never be recreated or duplicated. Each year, someone new arrives, and someone else leaves to begin a new adventure. As they leave, they become one of mine. Each knowing of this place is always their home. My career choice has given me so many beautiful memories, so many sleepless nights. I can't wait to roll over and not hear a song in my head. With so many wonderful friends and colleagues and teachers and family members of my students. I've enjoyed teaching choir and the challenge of teaching band and orchestra for the last 2 years. I was grateful to be able to teach in the same community where I grew up and stood and walked on the stage. I enjoyed coming to my alma mater and teaching and having the opportunity to watch the students learn and grow. It's incredible, incredible human beings. I'm blessed with words, and I know that the new director will feel exactly the same way that I do, because we are blessed. Now, I'm going to invite my children. Wait, we're going to sing Wonderful World, and then I'm going to invite the alumni to come up on stage and bring your children, and we will sing the alma mater. Thank you.
I don't want to get sappy before such a beautiful song, but I feel like What a Wonderful World is such a beautiful song because you made our high school life a wonderful world every day that we were in your class or we see you in the hallway. So I thought that this was a necessary time to give Ms. Lotz her own flowers from all the seniors, everyone up on stage. Thank you for keeping music alive in West Granders.
Oh, celebrating with